Hello everyone, in this video I'll tell you how this expansion, the early game, late game, what's new and cool and bad of course, and describe every way in which the Vessel of Hatred campaign sucks.
Or Eru, if you like.
Eru, thank you. But why?
I'll go back with the regular review formula because someone told me I'm bad, so I won't try new stuff too much. Oh Jesus, I'm so hot. Anyway! The gameplay overview. The developers deliberated whether to reintroduce a classic class from previous games or create a new one. Ultimately, they decided to go with the latter. Bad call. Well, I thought we get the Witch Doctor or Amazon, hell, even Paladin. But no. They decided somehow to make a monk and call it Spiritborn. Which is a good class, by the way. It plays fine, looks cool, so yeah, overall it's fun. I had no issues here, but it would have been my last pick though, as I said. I enjoy almost all endgame gameplay. Almost all activities are fun, especially now that I reach it faster because of the level squish. So you'll start off the expansion pretty much where the original game left off. Some stuff is happening, and long story short, some cinematics later you end up in Nahantu. Very cool looking area, consisting in a huge rainforest. It sure is a huge contrast compared with the neighboring regions, Kyrgyzstan and Hauetsar. I suggest you get the main quest as soon as you start and start doing it. Don't bother with the old world quests unless you play this for the first time. During leveling I noticed some stuff I didn't quite expect and some bugs and weird and confusing quest directions at times. It wasn't often, but yeah, let's just say that these things together with the story gave me bad vibes. Nothing much to add about leveling, it's the classical formula, oh chosen one, go there, kill that and take that and bring me that. Then the evil laughs manically while telling you how you can never prevail, then gets one shot. So yeah, the end. So the gameplay is pretty cool, but some collision bugs I'm not used to see in Blizzard games. And for example, I tried to complete a few side quests and one was bugged. Found that out online because it drove me nuts. I couldn't find the objective. And I saw many people were complaining about this. Then I had some collision issues. Now, let me tell you what's new compared with the base Diablo 4 and talk a bit about those things. Besides the new class and zone, we have a new endgame co-op activity. It is pretty cool, but I feel it could be way better. It consists in a new cooperative dungeon called the Dark Citadel. To unlock it, you need to reach level 60, of course, and the game will point you to the right direction with a series of purple quests. You'll be able to access the Dark Citadel from the Rise of Khazra waypoint in the middle of Nahantu. Don't do what I did and go in alone because you can't advance due to some mechanics that require coordination between two or more players. Just use the Party Finder feature which you'll find in the Social tab, by the way. The dungeon has three wings and after each wing you get rewards. Best advice I can give you is to keep an eye on the objectives because those tell you what to do, pretty much. To make a rough idea about what to expect, you have pressure plates and often two people need to stay on different plates. This is why it won't work solo. And yeah, you need to stay in a circle sometimes to kill enemies, to charge some soul siphons, and there are enrage timers in this, so you really need to have a party. Yeah, I managed to do it with randoms with no guides. So it's intuitive for the most part, only a few mechanics made us wipe more than, I don't know, 3 or 4 times. In the Dark Citadel you loot Khazra horns and you need those to transmute boss summoning items at the Alchemist. Now, the mercenaries. These are NPC companions that fight alongside you. Diablo 2 companions, basically. Sadly, you can't equip or gear them because it's hard to go all the way and make a good feature great, right Blizzard? There are 4 mercenaries to choose from and they are all sitting conveniently in the mercenary den, their base of operations. Among other things, you can barter in the den with the currency quest by gaining rapport with your companions. With pale marks, you can purchase stuff. Rune walls are back, thank god, and they are different from Diablo 2, but I like how they work. They are created by mixing 2 types of runes, invocation and ritual. The ritual runes are actions you can do to generate offerings and invocation runes consume the offerings to trigger an effect. And you mix and match your runes. They become in different rarities, of course they can be crafted and so on. Kura's Thunder City is the new time attack type dungeon and you can control the difficulty and rewards to some extent by paying tribute. Clearing elites and some events give you extra time on attunement, which boosts the rewards, of course. So, yeah, overall it's a pretty cool dungeon. Now a list of other changes. We get to spend 10 more skill points because of the leveling squish. Health, armor and core stats are also lowered. New difficulty system, there are 4 difficulties until you reach level 60, and at 60 you unlock torment difficulties. Sacred items are gone. Ancestral items drop from torment 1. 1 new skill and 5 new passives per class. I really like this one. Good job, Blizzard. So it's a good incentive to play one of the old classes if you don't fancy the Spiritborn,
the monk.
And to end this section, I'll talk a bit about the endgame. Not much to say here, but I liked it so far. Lilith fight is still shit, but I like how the game introduced me to every mechanic with those purple quests, so I rarely felt lost. And after I unlocked all dungeons and game modes, it felt I have good options to advance my character. And some resource is always dropping almost exclusively from one of these new activities. But yeah, when you enter the grinding mode, the game feels good. I forgot to mention the seasonal mechanic. I almost skipped it entirely, and I don't particularly like that. I mean, it's a bit boring and I feel it takes a lot of time for, yeah, not so good rewards. Chasing that thing slowly until he opens the portals feels bad, so I don't really like it. Graphics are very good, but I feel they don't have the sharpness of the vanilla Diablo. This is highly subjective and might be just in my head, by the way. What's not in my head is the amount of subsurface scattering someone put on my character, on my character's ears. My god, it's like I'm looking at a baby's head and someone is lighting his head with a strong stadium light or something from the behind, you know. Less is more. This was just a nitpick of mine. Graphics are really good, nothing else to add here. I especially like the character's skin shader and their eyes. So many developers do this wrong. And yeah, I'm looking at you, Starfield. Blizzard still does these things right. Sound as well. Good music and ambient sounds. I usually can't tell if sounds are missing from the world, but in this game they are all there, where you expect them. And I'd go as far as saying good voice acting, because it's not the actor's fault for what I'm about to say in the story.
A bone. King of flesh. Made flesh. Zul'mok. Anointed in Goron. Zul'mok in Goron.
And I hope you don't have big expectations from a game that consistently has side quest story better than the main quest. This will be a bit spoilery, so you can skip if you want, but TLDR is, if you play this game for the campaign, it sucks. There, now I'll give you some minor spoilers. First of all, Nyrell was so damn annoying. It's so whiny all the time. You know, I get it. It hurts, and they wanted to show you she's tormented by that prick. Then Eru is so dumb. He believes Mephisto from all things, so he makes a huge boo-boo by the end because Mephisto is so manipulative.
Ooh.
So poor writing, guys. I would have liked to see him manipulate Eru in time, you know. I would have liked to see it was a hard and long process for Mephisto to corrupt this pure soul. Not bam, now Eru is completely retarded. Deal with it. Now Rehir, your first mercenary, 1 second he tells you he won't leave his town and daughter for anything. Then he joins your party and leaves without a word. Cool story, bro. So yeah, all these things could be cool if explained a bit better. I will not like a character because you want me to like it, you know, but I'll do it if I resonate with him or her. And I resonate with characters that are well developed, not like this. I'm sorry. The campaign lasts for a good couple of hours. You had time to prepare the characters a bit. So yeah, try not to skip the dialogue challenge. I dare you. Tell me how it went in the comments, because after, I don't know, 1 hour or something, I skipped everything and I just watched the render cinematics and that was it. The performance is good. I mean, it's a well optimized game, especially after I played the Infernal Hordes. That game mode was new to me, but I found it came before Vessel of Hatred, so I didn't talk about it here, even if I wanted to. It's a great game mode, by the way. Nothing original, but great nonetheless. In there, I had good FPS with all my screen filled with monsters and FX. Maxed out with DLSS enabled. Yeah. Now the conclusion. I wasn't expecting this expansion like I did in the past. For me it's clear as day, the old Blizzard is no more. But they still make good games by today's standards. Almost all their games are polished and AAA, but they play it so safe it's disgusting. I feel I'm getting the minimum viable product by Blizzard standards every single time. I never feel I'm getting 800% value or out of anything they release, you know. And yeah, I know that's an unrealistic dream for sure. It would be a bad decision for them to give us more for less. Duh. But I strongly believe Blizzard is at this point in their life right now where they need to get back some of the trust they burned with all of us over the last couple of years. One more mention here, I forgot to say it earlier. At the moment, some build is extremely broken, meaning you clear the game by just dashing around. It looks and is retarded and will most likely be adjusted, so don't play that. I mean, play it, whatever, do what you want. A short recap on what I like and what I dislike with the expansion. Pros. The new area looks great, sounds are cool, endgame is varied and nice, the itemization is for the most part fixed, meaning whatever problems I had with vanilla Diablo 4 are mostly gone. Runelords are back, raids, well, sort of, I really hope they expand on this more. Timed dungeons, mercenaries are great, cat mounts, yes please, the progression feels good, and now the cons. The story is surprisingly bad, this is on top of the list, because it's the worst thing. So if you buy this for the story, I'm sorry for you, and the value proposition is quite bad. A lot of running around during the campaign only for a dialogue most of the time. Unexpected bugs in a Blizzard game, so perhaps 1 year development cycle is not sustainable with a small team, my guys. I don't know, I'm just saying. No Amazon, no Paladin, but yeah, we got a monk, a Spiritborn. Mercenaries feel like a missed opportunity, because they are. Catmounts feel slower than the horses, I'm pretty sure this is in my head. But I'm also sure it has to do something with the animations, they are too floaty. I'd like the cats to feel more, I don't know, planted into the ground and a bit snappier in the animations, how they move. And perhaps it won't look like they are slower. Because I don't think they are slower than the horses, but it sure feels that. Now, the free battle pass feels like shit as always, thank you Blizzard. The seasonal free cosmetic set is one of the worst I've seen. These things weigh differently for everyone and of course are highly subjective because, yeah, this is how it works. So even if your pros and cons list would look like mine, you'd give the game a different score. I'll even do something else this time, I'll not score the expansion myself. I'll let you, the viewer, do that. It sounds dumb, I know, because you would think this doesn't work like this, but you'd be surprised the amount of people who play the game or watching these types of videos. So I presented you my findings and my thoughts, and I'll make an average out of your comments to see what comes up. I won't even score it myself. This might turn up to be just another one of my bad ideas, I know, but we'll see. I'll pin a comment after a week or so with the average score. I'll release one more Diablo 4 video perhaps with a few cool tricks I discovered during these last few days and hopefully some Throne of Liberty guides I didn't have time to make. Yeah, thank you for watching up to this point, give me a sub if you did and fancy this channel. I like a lot of genres, so you won't feel bored, I promise. Probably you'll get just a bit bored when Microsoft Flight Simulator 2024 releases, because I'll play that one for a couple of months for sure. Thanks again, and until next time, take care and see ya.